Good morning, everyone. So glad we're here. This morning I was making a smoothie and I was thinking about food and vibration and the human vessel. Many of you know that I've kind of lived like a nomad the last year, traveling around and living in all kinds of different places around the country and traveling. And because of those things, I was not eating as appropriately as I've wanted. So I've gone through this stage of eating really clean to not eating so great, eating really clean to not eating so great, just depending on what's going on in my life. I've now been in San Francisco for almost 3 months and I've gotten myself into a little bit of a routine of balance, and I'm incorporating healthier things into my life. Well, during my transitional period of coming out here, I was not eating really great and I sort of gained a little bit of weight. And really, what it is most of the body fat that we have is really just swelling and inflammation. And so I recognize that that's what that is. Like, we don't realize how distended the belly becomes just by the things that we eat. And so, by eliminating things such as processed foods, anything that comes out of the can or the box, if you pick it up and you can't read the back of the label, it's probably not a good idea to eat those things. I still eat things like that sometimes. So, I go back and forth. I make sure that if I pick up a bag of chips occasionally, that I feed it, I fuel it with a smoothie behind it, or something like that to counteract. But I'm really getting in the direction of eliminating those things in my life. And so it just takes the awareness of it. So over the last week or so, I have really gotten much more disciplined in what I've been consuming. I've started eating some more smoothies and things like that. And I can already tell it looks like I've lost weight in the areas where I'm in my belly, but really it's just that swelling, that inflammation of those chemicals, that artificial food in my body. It takes a while for the body to detox from that. And we don't realize how much eating things that aren't real create an unreal frequency in the body. Literally, the brain tissue, the neurotransmitters, the flow of oxygen, energy, blood, neurotransmitters, all of those things in our bodies become altered when we fuel the vessel with artificial foods. And it's no wonder that we have such a problem with education in this country. Why people are depressed and frustrated easily. And if we just simply cut everything else out, like if we don't even really think about our emotions or any of that, and we just focus on on the food, on what we're drinking, what we're putting in our bodies, just focusing on that thing alone will raise the vibrational frequency of the human. The brain starts functioning better. The cloudiness moves out of the way. I mean, think about it. The vessel, the digestive system is crucial to the body. The digestive system takes the food that we eat, separates it all out, decides what the body can absorb for nutrients, and then it has to digest and detoxify what we're putting in it to be able to sort out the things that the body can digest and it can't. Well, if the human is only fueling the body with things that aren't real, such as soda, fast food, potato chips, flour, pasta, bread. Bread is like, I mean, anything that does not enhance the vibration of the body, those things are going to cause illness and disease because the body can't break those things down. They're chemicals that are foreign to the human vessel. It's not natural. So if the human can't digest those things, what happens to it? Well, it interferes with the mechanical, energetic flow of the machine that we call a body. And that affects our psyche. Like, I think that we are in a state in this world where everyone is so blind to the outside world of what's going on, that we're almost on automatic. It's like we're on one of those, those moving sidewalks where everyone's just kind of walking on them, doing whatever they've been doing their whole lives because that's what they're taught to do. And we have to break out of those patterns, family, because those things do not create a good vibration within ourselves. And I mean, think about it. We fuel our bodies. When you're hungry and you feel tired, do you want to fuel your body by eating a hamburger from McDonald's and drinking a Coca-Cola? Did you know that there's 8 ounces of sugar in one 12-ounce can of Coca-Cola? 8 ounce, an 8 ounce, a whole cup of sugar is in a soda. And people wonder why there's so much disease and obesity and all kinds of death food related illnesses that people just go, oh, I have high blood pressure, give me some medication. Oh, I have diabetes, give me some medication. Instead of going, I really should take a look at what it is I'm consuming, what I'm putting in my body, how I'm fueling my mind, so that we can redirect those things and heal ourselves. We can actually heal ourselves with food. We don't have to make ourselves sick with it. So the way that I do it is that when I have the money to splurge on the, or I am make, I'm sorry, let me retract that. I am making myself spend the money that I make on things that are healing my body. And so instead of buying, whatever I could spend my money on, I'm choosing to spend my money on things that I know that